I want you to do me a favor. Think of one thing that you can do to make the world better.
Eva's story is fascinating to listen to, and it really resonates for all ages.
I think that Eva's story is timeless. It doesn't matter what your background is or what you've gone through or who you are, her messages connect to us and we're inspired by them.
She was a 4'9" rock star. There's no other person I know that inspires me more than her.
We have a woman, a Hoosier, who's teaching the ultimate message about inclusion, about diversity, about empathy, about moral courage. I mean, I had never heard of Eva until the first time I went to see her speak. I thought there'd be 50 people there. There were 2,000. There were 4,000 eyes glued to this one woman, and mine were two of them.
Eva had this unique way of touching anyone at any age level, at wherever they were coming at. She just met them right where they were at, and I've never seen anyone be able to just connect with audiences as well as she did.
I was fortunate and blessed to go over with her, and that small group of, 15, spent 10 days with Eva in Germany and Poland, including 2 days at Auschwitz. You know, she was like a Pied Piper. You can't imagine how many young students that were in the camp that were coming through there would stop and start talking to her and ask her questions. Hopefully everybody in the state of Indiana and tourists from around the country that come here to see this exhibit can experience what we did.
The virtual reality experience is really incredible because you're gonna stand right where Eva stood, right where she would give her tours, right where she was at Auschwitz, and she's gonna explain to you what happened there.
There's nothing like sitting across from a teenager and having them tell you, often through tears, that they were ready to take their own life until they heard about Eva, they heard about her forgiveness, and they went to meet her, or they went on one of her trips. And not only did that repair them, but then almost unfailingly, they would go on to careers where they would help others. And I saw it again and again and again.
I included a little bit of everything, things that I thought would be an inside look at my mom and how she came, where she came from, and how she, you know, really used her terrible experiences, her terrible past, to empower herself.
We're thrilled that the Historical Society is going to take them on and put them, make them available in other formats, because it would be a shame if that material sat on a shelf or in a closet or on a computer somewhere at WFYI forever.
I'm so thrilled. I'll tell you, because you know, when you make a film, so much ends up on the cutting room floor. We had more stuff than anything that I've ever had before. And to now be able to see it displayed so beautifully, so engagingly at the premier research facility in the state, it's like a dream come true.
That's our job, to preserve history, to tell history, to tell the truth. This happened. And it needs to be told. As the chairman of the board, I am very, very grateful for the support from so many different segments of the community.
And I know that not everybody agreed with my mom. Once they go through the exhibit and interact with the virtual reality and see the movies and see the pictures and see the documents, I hope they have a better understanding of how to appreciate where my mom came from, the pain that she had to, you know, eventually let go of, and maybe they'll agree to disagree.
I mean, this is truly a hands-on, engaging exhibit with probably the most inspirational person I've ever met.
This is going to be different, and it's exciting.
I hope that people, when they come to this exhibit, take away the power that one individual can have to make a difference, the power that we have to triumph, to overcome our circumstances, and to be an advocate for hope and for peace and for community.
My parents aren't here anymore, and I think this is just an incredible way for people to learn about my mom in this case and learn about what she went through, and that hopefully her dream would be that people would use her story, use her life lessons to better themselves. You know, at the end of the day, it's really what my mom would hope for and want.